In this video, we will discuss about one more post-fertilization event or change, that is the development of dicot embryo. In case of dicot embryos, there are various different types of developments which have been explained. But the most common is what we are discussing. So let us start with this zygote. This is a diploid zygote formed as a result of fertilization. One male gamete and egg have fused to form this structure. And for our reference, we have to always mention the sides. So this is the chalazal end and here is micropyle end, because when we talk about the cells and their names, it is in reference to the site. I'll give you this example after a couple of stages are drawn. The divisions which take place in the zygote are all mitotic divisions. That means all the cells which are formed, they are going to be diploid cells. So now the zygote, it undergoes a transverse division to form two cells, and two cells, the cell which is towards micropyle is known as the basal cell, and the one which is towards chalaza is known as the terminal cell. In some place, they have mentioned that the upper cell is terminal and lower cell is basal, but this is in reference to the ovule. If we make the common type of ovule in angiosperms, that is the anatropous, upside down, inverted ovule, then lower side is the micropyle, upper end is chalaza. So here, micropylar end is lower end, chalazal end is upper end. But if you're making an orthotropous ovule, say if the ovule is orthotropous like this, and here is the zygote, it has undergone division to form two cells. So the one which is towards micropyle will be basal cell, and the one which is towards chalaza is going to be the terminal cell. So here it's going to be upper basal, lower terminal, whereas in this case it is going to be the lower basal and upper terminal. And that is why whenever we talk about this process, we don't use upper and lower. We give reference of the micropyle or the chalazal end. So the cell which is towards micropyle is the basal cell, and the one which is towards chalaza is the terminal cell. The further divisions, we will now give different colors to these cells so that it is easier for us to understand which cell is giving rise to which part. I have changed the color of the basal cell. Now, basal cell undergoes many divisions, transverse divisions, resulting in the formation of a long structure like this. How are these cells formed? This basal cell, say for example, this was the original basal cell, one transverse division to form two cells, both undergo transverse division to form four cells, and so on. So, the divisions in basal cells, transverse division in basal cells, result in the formation of a long structure. This long structure is known as suspensor. And the cell of the suspensor, which is towards micropyle, is slightly bigger, rounded, and is known as haustorial cell. What is the function of this suspensor? The suspensor is actually pushing the embryo deep into the endosperm. After we complete few steps, we'll try to draw that endosperm. Now, what has happened here? Basal cell, and I'm using the abbreviation, basal cell undergoes transverse divisions to form suspensor. this has the, or this is one change. The other change is going to take place in the terminal cell. Terminal cell undergoes division in all the planes. And when divisions take place in all the planes, we get a mass. So it divides to form two cells and then four cells. So this is known as the proembryo. So proembryo has developed from the terminal cell. So here we'll write down the change. Terminal cell divides to form proembryo. This proembryo will give rise to the embryo later on, and suspensor's function is to push that embryo deep into the endosperm. These divisions go on. Now what happens is, let us see what happens in the proembryo. It divides one more time, and now we start to see 8 cells. Here there are 4 cells. So in some books it is written as proembryonal quadrant. 4 cells, and that is why quadrant. These cells, they divide one more time and we start seeing 8 cells. So this structure will be called proembryonal octet. Cells are going to be in the form of mass. So few cells will be visible to us from front and few from the back. But because we want to give or write the fate of those cells, we draw them in a slightly different manner. We draw these cells like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. This is not the normal arrangement. Because the division is taking place in all planes, it is a ball of cells which is formed. So we don't see all the cells. But here we are showing all 8 cells. So this is called proembryonal octet. And this can be called proembryonal quadrant. Sometimes only proembryo is written, sometimes octant and quadrants are also written. Suspensor is going to remain as it is, but this proembryo is becoming bigger. So comparatively, the suspensor starts to look smaller. There is one cell of suspensor which is in contact with the proembryo. So this cell, the cell of suspensor which is in contact with proembryo, acts as hypophysis. So this cell acts as hypophysis. The other part of suspensor is going to be same. So here we are going to draw all those cells of the suspensor and the haustorial cell. So now there is a proembryonal octet, there is hypophysis, the suspensor is as it is, haustorial cell is also as it is. But comparatively, the suspensor looks smaller and the proembryo part looks bigger. Next change is one more division in the proembryonal octet. But this time the division is going to be periclinal. In periclinal division, there would be an outer cell and there would be an inner cell. So let us draw this proembryonal octet first, and then we will see how this periclinal division takes place. These are the 8 cells. Each cell divides in such a manner that there is now one outer cell, one inner cell. One outer cell and one inner cell. So there is an outer ring of cells formed. These outer cells will give rise to, or they are known as dermatogen, which will give rise to the epidermis or the outermost layer. This is one change which has taken place in the proembryo. 4 cells first, then 8 cells, and now periclinal division. So here we will say periclinal division in proembryo, which results into formation of dermatogen. The next change that we see is in case of hypophysis. Hypophysis again divides, and the division results in the formation of 8 cells. Again, the 8 cells are in the form of mass. we will still draw so that we are able to see all 8 cells because their fate is different. So we will draw those 8 cells like 2, then 4, 6 and 8. So these are the 8 cells of hypophysis. Again, they don't look like this. Hypophysis is again a mass of cells. Some cells are in front of us, some cells are behind what we are not able to see. But later on, we will write down the fate of these cells, and that is why we are showing all 8. Suspensor, it is still here. And the last cell is that haustorial cell. So this is how the structure is. Now, we will first write down the fate of these cells and then we will draw the changed structure in the embryo. We will divide it like this. The 4 cells of hypophysis now. 4 cells which are towards the suspensor. These cells, they give rise to root cap and root tip. The upper 4 cells means the cells which are in contact with proembryo, they give rise to root cortex. So when embryo is formed, the radical is formed, the radical is going to have a tip and there is going to be a root cap. That is going to come from these 4 cells which are towards the suspensor or which are towards micropyle. The cells of hypophysis which are towards the proembryo, they are going to give rise to root cortex. Now let us talk about these cells of the proembryo, the lower half. Lower half means the half of proembryo which is towards hypophysis or the half of proembryo which is towards micropyle. This is going to give rise to hypocotyle. And the half of proembryo which is towards chalaza is going to give rise to the plumule and cotyledons. And that is why we make the diagram in such a manner so that it gives us an idea that which part of the proembryo is going to give rise to which part of the embryo. So here it is a schematic representation. The embryo doesn't look like this exactly. But now we have an idea what is going to happen next. This part will give rise to the radical tip part. The cortex inner tissue will be formed by the upper cells. This will form the hypocotyle and cotyledons and plumule is going to come from here. To understand the significance of this suspensor, we are going to make this ovule here so that we understand what role this suspensor has played. Bitegmic, and here is the embryo sac and this was the zygote. So this zygote has divided to form these 2 cells, that is towards chalaza, the terminal cell, towards micropyle, the basal cell. And here is all that endosperm which has already developed. So this is the nutritive tissue which is formed. And we have already understood formation of endosperm. So this is the endosperm which is formed. Now we replace this whole thing with this structure. So here is our proembryo and the suspensor, which is actually formed by this basal cell, is here. So the point remains the same, but because of elongation, this structure is being pushed upward. So now proembryo has been pushed deep into the endosperm so that it is surrounded by the nutritive tissue. And that is what is the function of this suspensor, to push the proembryo deep into the endosperm so that it gets sufficient nourishment. What happens next? This particular form of embryo is known as globular. Now there is going to be a change which will take place in this. And that change will not only be in shape, but also there would be new tissues, new structures that would appear. That we will discuss in the next part.